What's up, y'all? It's your man Smoke back for another video. And today, man, as you can tell by the thumbnail and the title, we are back again, continuing the game series of Alan Wake 2. Right now, it is 12:52. It's about to be 1 o'clock right now. I don't know if y'all could see that. Hold on. 12:52. Okay. So, like I said, we gonna keep going at it. We gonna keep going at this game in the pristine moment where it should be played at night in the dark. We got a little bit of light, but. So what? At night, in the dark, we gonna attack this, okay? I keep looking over here because I see myself, but I need to be looking over here at y'all. We going to be attacking this game. We gonna be going at it. So let's go ahead and let's get right into it. What the heck? I was about to say, why the hell did it just shut off? I don't remember where we left off at. That's a lie. We left off at Alan Wake and Saga Anderson meeting together. They were, I guess, in the same location, wherever that could be. That's where we left off at.
I need to figure this out on the case.
Oh, it's on a playback. So this is like a playback of what happened, where we ended. But we already know that they're gonna end up together.
I can hear you.
Cauldron Lake.
Yes, I'm at Cauldron Lake. Where are you?
I'm trying to escape. In danger. The dark presence.
He has another piece of paper with him.
Are you okay?
He has a whole another piece of paper with him.
It got out with my face. Scratch.
Sir, calm down. I'm gonna need you to take a breath.
Why she say that so aggressive though?
Dark presence. We must stop it before.
Easy now. First things first. What's your name?
My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've been...
Wake? Where did you come from? You've been missing for 13 years.
13.
I ain't gonna lie, this song went fire. So I need to figure out what song this is, but we're not gonna listen to it because I don't want to get copyrighted and whatnot. Another trophy into the overlap.
Where did you go? All of a sudden the radio stopped working and then that flooding just disappeared. Crazy forest. Is this who I think it is?
Casey, say hello to Alan Wake. Mr. Wake, this is Special Agent Alex Casey. He'll escort you to our car. Casey, I'll meet you there, right after I take a look around. If the flooding's receded, there might be evidence we missed earlier.
Okay. See you there.
Am I still... Is this the dark place? No, it can't be. I got out.
Yeah, the PI from your books has the same name as me. Great. Moving on. It's a bit of a hike to the car, Wake. Get your bearings, then we'll head out.
I need another minute. Calder Lake.
Should look around.
I thought I'd never see this.
With the flooding gone, could be further clues out there. The flooding disappeared very suddenly.
Yeah.
I wonder if there's any connection to the overlap. To Nightingale.
It's getting dark. You have a flashlight? It's not safe without a light.
I have a light. And a gun.
I'm confused on where I'm supposed to be walking to. But they haven't moved at all either, so... kind of confused. Okay, a deer. Must be getting closer because the music, I guess, is an indication that you're on the right path, I guess. But still.
A locked box. Is that the cult of the tree symbol on it?
Yep.
Notes and ammo. Looks like they're tools of the trade. The cult doesn't see their victims as people.
Remember, they look like us, but they aren't. They're like animals. And it's our job to hunt and gut them. That's interesting. Okay, I guess that's all I was supposed to find, or maybe I'm supposed to continue. Another paper. Your bladder, you better say bless you. You better tell me bless you. can quickly turn. Okay. Okay. Oh shoot. This brought me back here. Oh shit. Are you serious?
Take a look at the case board to figure this out.
What the heck, bro? Wait, why my light not working? Oh, there you go. Okay, I forgot the button.
Even the animals are turning into monsters.
Forgot all about that. What's that noise?
I'm scared for this lady. I don't feel like she's gonna make it. But no, but what did that lady say? That one lady said that she knew her. And And then she feels bad because she had left because something about her daughter or something. Yeah. I wonder what that's all about. Like, is her daughter actually dead or something? Where's the guy at?
Mr. Wake, we're taking you back to our field office in Bright Falls. You can freshen up there, and then we'll talk properly.
Hey, Mom, before you say anything, I'm totally fine. Don't freak out. Dad shouldn't have even texted you.
Logan? No one texted me. What's going on?
I'm totally fine. I slipped, that's all. God, it's not the end of the world.
Put your father on the phone.
Okay. Dad, it's Mom.
Don't worry, hon. Logan slipped in the shower and bumped her head. She has a slight concussion, but I'm keeping an eye on her. Lucky I heard her fall. She could have drowned.
Jesus, David. Why didn't you call?
I tried. It didn't go through. She's fine, really. But what about you? You sound stressed.
No, it's just a weird case.
I'm confused, because, okay, if the lady at the fall at the diner
Colonel Mustard did it.
Said that she knew.
An eye out for him.
All right, hold on. Let me think about this.
Love you too, honey. Wanna say bye to Logan?
Just tell her I love her. Bye for now.
The lady at that diner where we went to go talk to the two witnesses, she said that she knew this lady. She said that she's new. Saga. I keep forgetting her name, but Saga. She keeps saying that she knew Saga. She had mentioned that Saga's daughter died. Right? Cool. If that is true, that Saga's daughter died. She also mentioned that it was from drowning. It's ironic because of what we just heard. But if that is true, that Saga's daughter did die, right? Who is she on the phone with? What is going on? Is this real? Is this moment real? Is Saga real? Is this all a story that's just going on in Mr. Wake's head? Is her partner real? Is any of this real? Because if that is true, that her daughter died, that means when her on the phone, she's not really talking to anybody. That means if she's not talking to anybody while she's on the phone with her quote-unquote daughter, her partner is watching her not talk to no one, which is outrageous and strange. If that's also the case, would you not report that your partner is talking to people who aren't there? Like, why would you want a partner that's crazy? The partner is weird on his own. Casey or whatever, that nigga weird off rip. But that's just where my mind is at right now. Let's continue. They always drink coffee at the same time. That's weird, bro. That's weird. That's not normal.
Is there anyone you'd like us to reach out to, Mr. Wake? You've been gone a long time.
No. No. They'd be in danger. It'll come for me.
Okay, let's talk about something else. Robert Nightingale. Do you know him? You were both here in 2010.
The Dark Presence got him back then. That's the last time I saw him. 13 years. Oh, fuck me.
Tell us about the pages. You had what looks like a title page with you. Return. Is this the name of the story on these pages? The writer's name has been scratched out pretty violently, but your name can still be made out underneath.
Scratched out. Yeah. Scratch.
Did you write these pages, Mr. Wake?
I'm trying to remember. It's a crazy jumble, like a nightmare. It doesn't make sense.
That's the first time that door has been opened. Late night.
Waking up in places with no memory of how I'd gotten there. It was out of control. I didn't need another mugshot in the fucking tabloids. Had I already done the show?
What? Which show does this remind? Where is he? Wait, where is he from?
This must be an exciting time for you. Tell me, does it ever get old?
Sorry, does what get old?
Publishing a new book. Are you okay there, my friend? You look like you've been cooped up in the writer's room for a few too many years.
This is exactly how I feel.
You know, I've waited so long to get my hands on the sequel to Departure. You left us on quite the cliffhanger. We've all been dying to know what "it's not a lake, it's an ocean" really means.
You and me both.
Well, our wait is over. Your new book, Initiation, hits the shelves tomorrow.
What?
That's exactly what every reader will be asking. This book is mind-bending. It's so cerebral. I mean, how would you describe it? An auto-fictional thought experiment? A horror story? A postmodern detective story?
Wait. This isn't right. I haven't written anything.
He's so humble.
Okay, you got me. Good prank, very funny. But yeah, sad to say, I've not written this. I'd remember if I'd written a book, right?
Or maybe it was written by your evil double. Well played, man. That is spot on. Playing the role.
He's crazy. I don't
think the world of the book overlaps our own. That's very meta indeed. You see, Initiation tells the story of a fictional writer named Alan Wake, who is trapped in a nightmare, desperately trying to find the manuscript of a novel he has forgotten he has written. The book is set in New York, but it might not be New York at all. He is tormented by his dark doppelganger and guided by visions of a fictional detective he has written. That's right. Alex Casey is in this book as well.
I guess we'll just keep doing this the whole show. The joke's on me.
But isn't that what you sign up for with autofiction? No, but seriously, I found the structure of the reality you build in the book fascinating. It reminded me of The Matrix. I mean, the writer is physically in his writer's room, trapped there.
Where is this guy from? This
dark dream of New York.
I've seen him somewhere.
Like astral projection. Did I get that right?
Yeah, that's exactly right. Go on. I should be taking notes here. This is great stuff.
Notes to that other Alan Wake in that room writing this as we speak?
Yeah.
Are we all in your story, Alan? Wow. No, I wish you every success with your new book, Alan. I hope it's as successful as your best-selling Alex Casey series. Initiation hits the shelves tomorrow. After this, I'm sure we'll all be eagerly awaiting the culmination of this hero's journey trilogy of yours. A book called Return, perhaps.
Return?
Yeah. Thank you for one of the strangest interviews of my entire career, Alan. All this talk of meta-narratives. I'm expecting to disappear once this scene ends.
Okay, hold on. The dude who was doing the interview mentioned that within the book that Alan Wake wrote, he has a doppelganger where they switch roles and one writes, or maybe they both write. But he doesn't remember. Right? So maybe anytime he's in that place, that dark place, right, that he keeps talking about, where everything, the only way to beat them is with the light, right? Maybe that's because the doppelganger is essentially taking over. I don't know what it's called. What is... I don't know what the thing is called, right? Let me look this up. Get on, let me see what it's called. Multiple personality disorder. Okay, so this is okay. So DID, also known as multiple personality disorder, with the official name is dissociative identity disorder, which is where I guess they get the DID from. And basically the summary of it is a mental disorder where a patient has two or more personalities. It can caused by multiple different types of trauma. Two or more personalities, memory lapses, and abnormal behavior. So maybe that's what he has, right? Maybe this other personality is taking over at random moments in time. And because of the other personality taking over, he doesn't remember. He doesn't remember any of it. So let's continue.
Hello?
Like, he was just on the show. He didn't remember the book. He said, I didn't write that book. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't have a book coming out. Once the interview's over, switch. Now he's still in this interview place.
I'm losing it. Something's not right here.
But nobody's there.
To get home to Alice.
It's as if he's in another world. I don't have a weapon. Don't have anything, but
what the hell was that interview? Some kind of joke? Initiation? I never wrote a book called Initiation. This felt like a bad dream. Could make a good horror story.
Old Gods of Asgard?
Old Gods of Asgard. Name sounded familiar. I was a mess. I'd never heard of this talk show or Mr. Door before. None of it felt right. Was I losing my mind?
Mr. Door. Guy's literal name is in between with Mr. Door. This had a big 665. Neighbor of the Beast. How many numbers are on this pen? Okay, 665.
There was something here. A broken transmission I couldn't quite make out. What was that? A message? Impossible to say.
It was him locked in a room. Writing. It was him locked in a room writing.
Waking up from the nightmare, I felt like a drowning man gasping for air. This place felt familiar. A ghost of a memory surfaced about riding here for countless days. For mapping out a story. On the index cards, the nightmare that just happened to me. A summary of the story so far. But other notes as well. Warnings. I had written them. I couldn't remember what it all meant. The name Scratch filled me with dread. I could trust these words. I had to act on them. You must write to escape.
And this is, I think this is the part that it's interesting, right? Because he was just at the studio. He was having an interview that he didn't remember how he even got there. The host, Mr. Door, mentions the fact that he, within the book that is supposed to be dropping, has an alter ego who, I don't know if it's him or the alter ego, is locked in the in essentially a room that he can't escape, and is stuck and is suffering because he can't do nothing but write. All he can do is write in that room. He tries to leave the studio. But before he does, he gets pushed into this other world, which I would believe is because his other alter ego is taking over. I don't know if you guys ever seen the movie. What is that movie? A movie called Glass, but it was a character within a movie that I'm talking about specifically. Split. It's a movie called Split, and in the movie Split, it's someone with DID or multiple personality disorder who essentially has just a bunch of personalities, and it gets real wild and stuff. But within that movie, he explains multiple times how every time someone is, or the one of the personalities is in control, they call it the light. They call this the person or the individual has the space, right? Because within the light, you essentially get the control of the person's conscious, your memories, eyes. Picture of it like a little person in your head, right? The only form of light they would be able to get is from your eyes. So if the person is sitting in the seat where all the light is directed, or it has control of the light, they would be the person up front viewing the world through your eyes. I think that's kind of like what this is. he keeps referencing the only way to fight the darkness is with the light, right? So essentially the light is, again, this is all a theory. I'm still playing it. This is a theory. It seems like it's the same concept. The light for him is for him to be able to be in control, and the way for him to fight his alter ego or the darkness is for him to get control or be in the light as long as possible. But it seems like he can't even do that. Like he keeps getting kicked into the back seat. So, but theories, just all theories. Let's continue.
I didn't remember much, but I knew my thoughts.
Okay. I remember what I was getting to. The reason why I say that is because he's in this room and he's writing. He's getting there. He's seeing these things that were written by him, but he doesn't know how. He doesn't remember writing them. So he says the only other way that he can do it is by to continue to write. So for me, I find it interesting because if it's a thing where they're continuously switching and they're both writing, right? It's like they're having a conversation, like they're talking to each other, but it seems like the one doesn't want this version of him to be able to escape, but they're talking to each other. Because if he's writing something and he's putting it up on the board and then they switch, the other version of him is going to see that. So it's like, how do you escape if the person keeping you captive has the chance to see all of your plans for you to escape? You get what I'm saying? So, but let's go.
Ideas could manifest as reality in this dark place. I'd use my writing to project myself out of this room, like a deep sea diver to go deeper and explore the depths of this prison for a way out. This room is my boat. Writing was my lifeline.
Welcome back to the show. So, Alan, as the creator of the character, how do you feel about this?
Sorry, what?
I know it can be an awkward question with the man sitting right next to you, but I mean, how do you feel about him in the role of Casey? Does he look the part to you?
He looks exactly like I always imagined Casey to be. It's uncanny.
Thank you. That means so much to me. I'm a huge fan of your books.
So, what's the problem, Alan? Because on more than one occasion, you voiced your reservations about the adaptations.
It's not that. They're their own thing. They've gone with choices that are different from mine. I feel protective about my stories, and these adaptations... I don't know. I guess I just wish I could have been more involved in making them.
Well, in that case, you won't have seen this either. We have a clip from the new film, Murder Case Casey. Should we roll it, or do you want to say something first, Sam?
Nah, just roll it.
This city was an old scar that refused to heal. Sun, but there was only the night. I was tired. insomnia covered me like a plastic film. I was watching the world through a rain-slick window, my own reflection haunting the view. I was trying to track down a missing writer. My only clue was a table lamp shaped like an angel, the only thing that shed light on this sordid mystery.
Casey, great job, Sam. Very exciting and very meta. I'm looking forward to seeing more.
Wait, stop. What was that about a writer? About a lamp?
Back at it again. It's different.
So much evil that not a bit of good as well. Not one without the other. Good to see you.
What?
Hey, I can't seem to find my way out of here. Can you point me to the exit?
Of course, Tom. The work will instruct its maker. I was gonna get something from the basement for you, but you can get it yourself now. The more cooks, the worse the soup.
Have we met before? Are you trapped in the dark place too?
You remember Ahti, the janitor. You can't be lost if you don't worry about where you are headed. So don't worry, Tom. The sun will shine even into a heap of twigs.
He keeps calling him Tom.
Just remember to turn on the lights.
Why does he keep calling him Tom?
It'll take long when you get to work.
What do you want me to get from the basement? And my name's Alan, not Tom.
Yeah, but I got up, a man, but a man with a tool makes two, Tom. And a man with a tool can build his own exit. It's in a shoebox, in the basement where you left it. Safe as in the Lord's purse. Here's the key.
I've been trying to find a way to escape the dark place. Any suggestions?
He who mulls about his troubles is the prisoner of his troubles. It's not easy to get out. But don't you worry, Tom. The home is still there where the heart is. I often think about it when I mop the floor and look into the puddle. Water is the memory of the world, water finds its way.
The janitor was a bit out there, but still a friendly face. I had to trust the basement would get me out of here.
The basement. Basement. Okay, wait a second. This is a stage. I went from the stage back. I got into this room. Then I hit the door. Somehow I got here. It's janitor's room, cafeteria. Wait. Workshop exit. Okay. I guess this is gonna help me somehow. Just a man with a tool can build his own way out. So I'm guessing you're supposed to be looking for tools.
Lamp and a shoebox. Was this what the janitor had left for me?
Some light.
The lamp felt significant. A tool for bringing light to the darkness. I felt a magnetic pull between the lamp and the light overhead. Jumped into my lab. The whole room changed, like something in a dream. Opening a way forward, the lamp was humming. The bulb glowed. It held the light now.
Okay. Okay, but still no weapon.
I felt another surge from the lamp. I could use it again. out something new from the darkness. I needed to find another way out. Wants to drown me. I'm losing myself. I have to fight it. I have to remember. The clicker. The light switch. I lost it. But I have the lamp now. The lamp the switch was cut from. This place is a nightmare. Not real, and yet more real than anything. The danger and the horror are real. It feeds off my mind. Twisting whatever it takes into psychotic reality. I'm trapped here. I write to escape. I've tried this many times, written countless stories, forgotten how many. I keep failing, but I must keep trying. I use the story to dive deeper. Every word I write is a step forward on this spiral in the darkness. I dive to the body to find the answer, the map, the key, the compass, that's combined to form a door leading out. But how do you open a door that's not a door? At the bottom of an ocean that's not an ocean, and a lake? That's not a lake.
Hey man, I appreciate I appreciate everyone who, again, who is joining me on this journey when it comes to this game. And I really hope y'all enjoy it, man, because I'm enjoying it. And I hope y'all enjoying it. I hope you like the game. It's a very, very, very interesting game. But I just want y'all to be able to feel as if like we're coming together and we're doing this together. So I want to say thank you. I appreciate everyone who stayed to this point. And everyone who's going to join us moving forward till we get to the end of the game. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Make sure if you do enjoy the video, you do enjoy the game, please make sure you leave a like, make sure you comment, make sure you subscribe, make sure you click that notification bell. And also make sure you share the video to someone that you also feel like is going to like the content that I'm making, who might like the game, who might like my raw, uncut reaction to this. So, yeah, man. This is episode, what, 4, 5, whatever. I don't even know. I don't. But, hey, man, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm gonna catch y'all in the next video. Peace.